أصحاب السعادة، الضيوف الكرام، السيدات والسادة، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. سعدنا أن نرحب بكم جميعاً في منتدى الأعمال لدول حوار التعاون الآسيوي الذي يمثل مناسبة مهمة في بحث سبل توطين أواصر التعامل التجاري والاستثماري بين الدول الأعضاء في هذه المنظمة الرائعة التي تمثل والتي تم تأسيسها منذ حوالي 17 عاماً لتكون منصة جامعة لكل الدول قطر.
أصحاب المعالم السعادة، السيدات والسادة، ضيوف الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. يجب لنا بداية أن نرحب جميعا تنادينا لكم قيمة الطاعة في دولة قطر وشاكرين لكم حضوركم ومشاركتكم معنا في منتدى الأعمال لدول حوار التعاون الأسيوي الذي يعد منصة مهمة لبحث سبل تعزيز الشراكة والتعاون الاقتصادي بين الدولين. السيدات والسادة، شهد حوار التعاون الآسيوي طورا كبيرا منذ تأسيسه في العام 2002 وبات يعد اليوم من أحد أكبر المنتديات السياسية والاقتصادية بالعالم، حيث يضم أكثر من 34 دولة آسيوية لتجاوز حجم سوقها 4.4 مليار نسمة.
Excellency Minister, Ambassador, Representative of Chamber of Commerce across Asia, ladies and gentlemen, in the past decade, everyone is talking about the success of Asia, the miracle of Asia. At that time, our growth model, what export we based on labor intensive, which was relevant to the third industrial revolution at that time. However, the current global environment is moving from the third to the fourth industrial revolution, the so-called information revolution. This is the reason why we would like to continue our prosperity in a sustainable manner. We need a new growth model with new growth engine. The model that information and creativity are major drivers of our growth in the future. There are so many ways and means to strengthen the new competitive nation. But for Asia, enhancing our small and medium enterprise is the most relevant factor to sustain growth in the long term. Small and medium is the backbone of our economy, particularly in Asia. Small and medium actually play an important role in the overall social and economic well-being and prosperity. Strengthening SME will at the end restructure supply chain from being labor-intensive to being innovative lead model and enhancing our intellectual capital and human capital. Especially, small and medium-sized enterprises make a significant contribution to the economy of Asia. They account for more than 89% or more of all enterprises in most countries.
Senator Duzerne, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me a great pleasure to join the Business Forum of the members of the Asian Cooperation Dialogue. And I want to thank the members of Qatar for taking this initiative to host the Business Forum on the theme Small and Medium Industries and New Engines of Sustainable Economic Prosperity. This forum holds immense potential for stakeholders from ACD to promote partnership and cooperation. Let me just give you a brief outline of how India has profited from the micro and small and medium industrial sector. The Indian economy has been growing over 7% for several years, and the forecast is that India's future is equally robust. At this rate, we would become a 5 trillion economy by 2025. And India's economic landscape is changing and changing very fast. The international business community has given a vote of confidence this growth that is taking place by investments that they have done in India. During the last financial year, we received $62 billion in foreign direct investment in India. And Indian industry is also reaching out to the world through trade, direct investments, joint collaborations. And let me also say that numbers don't really capture the enormous changes that are taking place.
First of all, I would like to express my appreciation and thanks to His Excellency Mr. Ahmed, al-Kuwari, Minister of Trade and Industry of the 10th Country, Qatar, for coordination and cooperation with ACD. I'm inviting the Islamic Republic of Iran to participate in this event. Taking this opportunity, I want to convey greeting and thanks from His Excellency, the Minister of Industry, Finance, Trade, to all the past and seniors who participated in this important event. I hope the Asian Cooperation Dialogues Member Countries Trade Meeting will be an effective and new chapter for enhancing economic integration and boosting cooperation among the members of the member countries. 34 members of ACD producing 29% of world GDP and high 56% of world population. They have big production, commercial, economic, social, and political capacity. The ancient